Given the anniversary, the ramped up security, and the running records, it was indeed a memorable Patriots Day in Boston. We check in now with two who were out there for it. Maria Cramer of the Boston Globe, she joins us this evening from the Boston Common. And Adam Reilly of WGBH Public TV in Boston. Maria Cramer, how did the day go overall? What would you say?
There were so many police officers out there, and I have to say it was very calm. The crowds were very well behaved. They listened to the instructions, which were don't come in with backpacks, please abide by these rules, and the day should go pretty well. And in Boston so far, from what I hear, there's been only one arrest for disorderly conduct. It looks like it's been a successful day in terms of security.
Adam Reilly, what would you add? How did you feel it went?
I would echo the point Maria made. I mean, the mood in Copley Square, where I was right by the finish line, the mood was extremely relaxed. I tried to find people who might take issue with the enhanced security, and I wasn't able to find anyone, much like the people you quoted in your setup piece. People basically said to me, this is probably the single safest spot in the country or maybe on the planet right now. And if this is the price we have to pay to feel safe and to be able to conduct the marathon a year after what happened, we're fine with it. So very relaxed. And it was interesting, the enhanced security, sometimes at things like presidential nominating conventions, you'll detect a little animosity between, say, members of the media and security personnel, or security personnel will sort of wear their authority heavily. And at least where I was, that was not the case today. It was very low key. And I think probably more effective as a result.
Maria, what did you feel that was different about security this year? What was visible that was different?
There were a lot more dogs, and there were streets that were closed that are normally not closed. And Boylston Street, which is a street where people can go back and forth very easily, they have a lot of freedom and access to that area, that was closed by noon. No more pedestrians were allowed onto that street, to the annoyance of some people who were trying to get on from nearby Newbury Street. But, you know, like Adam said, most people understood this is what it has to be like. So it was. Very, very tight in terms of where you could walk. That's not the kind of marathon most people in Boston are used to. And I don't know if that's what it's going to look like next year. It'll be interesting to see if they replicate this. But I think police really feel like this was the way to handle it, and most spectators agreed with them.
Maria,
Adam,
go ahead.
I'm sorry for jumping in. I was going to underscore Maria's point. To have Boylston Street closed off, I believe, from the Boston Public Garden to Massachusetts Avenue, that's a big deal. I was trying to connect with my cameraman earlier this morning, and it took me a good, 45 minutes to basically do the equivalent of crossing a street in 2 minutes. Now, that's not a big deal because it was an inconvenience for me, but as Maria mentioned, I think a lot of spectators were kind of thrown. There were times when it was a little unclear about how you were supposed to get from point A to point B, but again, general acceptance was the rule.
Maria, you go ahead. Go ahead. I want to hear what you have to say.
Oh, well, I was going to say exactly what Adam said. Basically, they'd been advertising this for a while. The police had been pretty vocal about what they were going to do, especially in Boston, where the marathons bomb struck last year. They told people, be prepared for this, but people weren't prepared. Many of them were perplexed and cursing under their breath a couple of times. So you had some surprise on that level, and it was confusing, but The goal was to have as few people on Boylston as possible so that police and anti-crime units, plainclothes officers, could move around, and that's what they seem to have accomplished.
Maria, did you sense there was an effect on the runners themselves? I know there were, 9,000 more than last year?
I think in a way there was, because the crowds are usually a little thicker along Boylston Street, and you saw some runners sort of, throwing their hands up, trying to get the cheers and the screams to be a little louder. And I was asking some spectators who come year after year, and they said, yes, usually you have more people along Boylston Street. And they said, it seems like people are a little bit more subdued, and I don't know if it's because they're looking for things, if they're looking on the street to see if any bags have been left behind, if there was any fear. So there was a calmness to this marathon that you normally don't see. It's normally a much rowdier event, and I think there was a sort of feeling of let's just see if everything's okay,
Adam,
before we get too excited.
It's interesting that Maria says that. I actually heard something a little bit different from a couple runners at the finish line. I had one woman tell me that the crowd, which is known for being an incredibly supportive crowd, that it was sort of even more passionate and supportive this year than in previous years. But that just goes to show you, you know, that these things are subjective. I think that a lot of the runners I talked to decided that they were going to run because of what happened last year. That was why they were here today, or a big part of the reason. But they also told me that once the race began, by and large, they put last year's events out of their minds.
And Adam, did you get a sense from people that they hope that this kind of security is not there indefinitely?
I did not hear that from a single spectator or a single participant. But it will be really interesting to see. Maria mentioned what subsequent marathons are going to look like. And I think that's the huge unanswered question. Is this security going to become standard? Is there going to become a point, you know, after which people start to chafe at this? This year, everyone was a little bit anxious, even though we all assumed it was a very, very safe event. I think there was still sort of a collective sigh of relief when it ended without anything weird or unpleasant happening. 2 years from now, or 5 years from now, or 10 years from now, that discussion may be different.
Adam Reilly, WGBH, Maria Cramer of the Boston Globe joining us. Maria, thank you from the Boston Common.
Thank you.